compliance issues in your own backyard, like Greece, for example, where you come from. But recently there was a development with the Macedonian Orthodox faith-based community in Greece, and they've been trying to build a Macedonian Orthodox church in Odessa. And most recently, their spiritual leader was fined 45,000 euros by the city, and from money that he had raised from his community of 57,000 euros to build this church. So I wanted to seek your advice on how can Greek citizens or citizens of the EU tackle some of these problems in countries that are part of the EU, and so what are the tools accessible through the EU system to tackle some of these.
Yeah, and I have no idea what kids are talking about, and I hear periodically about the similar stories around the EU. They tend to be exceptions, of course, but frankly, thankfully, there is a legal system in the European Union, in the different member states, in Greece as well and others, that allows for citizens that feel that that their rights are violated to be able to sue. So Greece and every EU member state is a part of the Council of Europe and have signed the European Convention for Human Rights. At the same time, the Charter of Fundamental Rights of the European Union itself applies to all member states when the laws that are being violated are European Union laws. So if it would be an anti-discrimination law, for example, there's an EU law, that also would apply. And the process is that you can do anything from going to the ombudsman and raising the issue and having a mediation through that, to suing in court, to eventually, if you're not happy with the exhaustion of your remedies in a particular member state, going to the European Court of Human Rights in Strasbourg under the Council of Europe and suing there. So there are a number, if you're asking me what would I advise people who feel that their rights are violated, there are a number of things that you can do in Europe, thankfully, to address this. And if I may use that question to raise a broader point, which I think is quite interesting, at least in my job. One of the things that bad countries, bad human rights countries, tend to ask me when they feel cornered is, who are you to talk? Mm-hmm. So, so who are you to talk? Look at racism in Europe, look at the immigration issue, look at this, that, the other. And the question, of course, is not being asked in order for us to sit down and put our heads together and try to actually resolve, be better altogether in human rights. It's being asked mostly to say, you're also bad and I'm also bad, and let's not just discuss this anymore and let everyone do their own thing. So I've been thinking about this question quite a bit, and I think there is an answer to this question that is quite overwhelming. Because it is the true answer, in fact. What is the litmus test in human rights? Is it perfection? If it is perfection, then of course no one passes it, because no one is perfect by definition. Now, mind you, the fact that no one is perfect does not mean that therefore everyone is equally imperfect, which would be the desire also of that argument to sort of make you assume. But okay, but if the litmus test is not perfection, what is it? And my answer to that is the litmus test is whether or not you have in place in your country, in your region, the institutions, the independent institutions, that do not allow you to shove your imperfections under the carpet. In other words, you may not be perfect, but do you want to try to be? Do you have independent courts that will prosecute a policeman who is accused of a human rights abuse? And will not allow impunity to happen, even if the government wants impunity to happen? Do you have an independent press where human rights allegations and violations can be raised without those raising them being prosecuted for defaming the country or defaming or whatever? Do you have an independent parliament where different political parties can debate those issues freely? Do you have independent national human rights institutions and those people? Fundamentally, do you have a free and independent civil society that you may not like or agree with all the time, but that exists, that you talk to, and that their opinions and ideas you can take into account?